Hey y'all, hi. So a couple of weeks ago, I tried to declutter my entire wardrobe and panicked. I made a whole video about it, which I will link in the cards and down below. And in that video, I came to the conclusion that I needed to sit down with my personal aesthetic inspiration for fashion and clarify my vision. And that's what I'm going to be doing with you in this video. I've got my Pinterest board here. We're gonna scroll through it. We're gonna look at some individual images and just kind of think out loud about where I think I might be going as I continue down this path of trying to sculpt my wardrobe into something smaller and stronger, basically. For those of you who are new, I make videos about fashion and aesthetics and makeup. I really am on a quest for fewer, nicer things. My name is Hannah. I'm also a writer. I'll link my book in the description box down below. A lot of times my fashion videos are a little bit more essayistic and scripted. This one's not gonna be like that. It is just kind of a hangout. And then maybe down the line, I'll make a more essayistic video about where I think that I'm going with my wardrobe. But I think that I just need to steep myself, just stew in these images. And, you know, I'm going to do that with you. I'm going to do that on camera and post it on the internet. Let's go ahead and get into the meat of the video. So in the video about trying to declutter my wardrobe and panicking, I decided that I needed to sit down with my inspiration because I realized that procedurally, what I'm going to have to do is to kind of shop my own closet for a capsule wardrobe. So like pick and choose from what I have to create a much smaller wardrobe and just try living with that and wearing that. And then maybe in the not too distant future, sell the things that I didn't choose. So what I'm trying to do here is to get a vision in my mind's eye of what I want my capsule wardrobe to look like. Basically, like, how do I want to dress? And to me, a capsule wardrobe, because it has fewer things in it, does need to have a more distilled aesthetic point of view. It's like, I want to have a vision of the way that I dress every day, all of it kind of hanging together and singing together, almost as if it's all looks from the same runway show. You know what I mean? Like a more specific sense of personal style. I'm ready for that for a lot of reasons. And one of them is just ease, but also another one is aesthetic. Like I think I'm ready to go hard in one direction rather than kind of spreading myself all over the map in terms of what I try with my closet. Because I'm old, I'm starting to kind of settle down, you know, and I feel really ready to do that. And I'm excited to do that. And looking at my Pinterest board here, what am I covered with hair? Yeah. Looking at my Pinterest board here, my first thought is, yeah, clearly. And I've been pinning these images casually for a while now. I've just, every once in a while, I go on Pinterest, I scroll around, I search for terms, I search for pictures using terms. And then I just save things to this board, which is called Personal Style, that has previously been private because I was keeping it a surprise, this video. But I'll make it public and I'll put it down below so you can go to the board and look at it for a long time if you want to. So I've been saving these images. And my criteria has been this. My single criterion has been, would I wear this entire outfit for real in real life? I've only pinned things here where I'm like, yes, I would absolutely wear this entire thing. I would like to own and wear this entire outfit. It's not just that there's one thing that I like about it. Everything is a 100% yes. I haven't really been thinking about any specific colors or silhouettes or anything. I've just pinned things that I would 100% wear. But when you look at it, it's like, girl, talk about a specific. I'm trying to avoid the word narrow, but that's what keeps springing to mind, a narrow aesthetic point of view. But I just mean cohesive, you know, like really cohesive within parameters that make it all hang together and make it so that I can mix and match the pieces effortlessly. It's not like all of these outfits are the same or look the same. They are not. It's just the color palette is extremely limited. And that excites me. That's the first thing that's jumping out. So let's talk about that first. I've only pinned things that I would actually wear. And I've looked at a lot of images of things with all different colors, all different kinds of outfits, all different patterns, all different palettes. And I've only pinned white, cream, black, taupe, white, cream, black, and taupe. Like I have literally pinned an entire mood board of incredibly neutral outfits, almost exclusively white, cream, and black. The pops of color that are there are brown, a little bit of camel, and taupe, but no cool toned gray, no steely gray. The grays are all that kind of super warm, almost creamy gray. If you've been around, you know that I've been moving in this direction for a while, and I have talked in videos. I'll pin them. I'll pin the fashion playlist down below. I'll post them in the description box. I'll copy paste the links. Okay. I'll put the links in the description box of videos kind of showing this journey that I've been on from maximalism to minimalism. And I'm going to make more. All right. Hot topic heading into the new year. One of the things I've realized is that not only do I feel most myself and honestly feel like I look my best in these specific neutrals, black, cream, and sometimes taupe and camel, but only dressing in these colors, it simplifies things so much. It makes me feel so confident and so polished every single day. And it makes it so much easier to get dressed. And even though I have clothes with prints on them, clothes in stronger colors than this, I have been actually dressing only from the small wedge of my wardrobe that is only these colors and feeling better than I've ever felt in my life and my clothes over the past year or two. So it makes total sense to me that this mood board is so monochromatic, but it still shocks me to see it. I've been pinning the images and I haven't been going back to review. Like basically here now is the first time I've sat back and looked at it and been like, okay, what am I getting at? And what I'm getting at is I would like to wear all cream, looks like at least 50% of the time. And I would like to wear all black, maybe 20% of the time. And then the rest of the time, I'd like to mix cream and black and mix in some brown, camel, and like taupey gray. If I didn't know me and I looked at this, that's what I would say. That would be my assessment about the person who created this board. But as those words come out of my mouth, they are true. They're true. And I feel free. It's like a sense of freedom. I feel so relieved to be able to let go of the burden of trying to do more than just that. And the thing is, when you just do that, look how good it looks. I mean, doesn't it look good? Like, I feel like this looks really good. I mean, I know I created this mood board, but it just, I feel like these outfits look really good. And this closet, I'm excited about it. However, a question is raised, and that's this. What about the pops of cherry red? Because I have some pieces in my wardrobe that are very bright cherry red that I really do love and identify with and kind of consider part of my palette. And then I have that one really bright blue sweater that creates contrast with all of this neutrality. So I've been pinning these images, but I know that I have a couple of brightly colored pieces that I will probably keep. So I'm looking at it and I'm really feeling myself and feeling this. And then I'm like, but is it going to be all this neutral or are there going to be some pops of color in actuality? And let's look at the one image that has color in it to discuss this concept, try to answer this question. This is from a Max Mara ad. It's an all camel outfit with a blue bag. This creamy sky blue suede bag. I think this is absolutely stunning. This blue, this shade of blue, is a color that I have loved in my life for a long time that I would consider adding as just like a single statement piece to my wardrobe when I have a capsule wardrobe of almost entirely neutrals. And that, as it's coming out of my mouth, I'm like seeing the words in the speech bubble floating over my head and I'm like, that's it. Grabbing them down, remembering them. That's it. I love how calm and polished this very confined color palette makes me feel in my dressing in day to day. I feel very aligned with the clothes and that makes me feel calm and it makes me feel like I present in a more polished and put together way, as opposed to having like a riot of color, which there's nothing wrong with. I should have said this at the beginning. I'm talking entirely about myself here. I'm not saying this is the best way to dress. This is so personal, right? It's very specific to me. I know there are a lot of you out there who are maximalist dressers, and I hope that you'll be able to do what I'm doing for myself, for yourself, and that we will be like this, you know, doing the same thing, doing it together, but your outcome will be different because you'll have a different mood board and you have different personal style and different garments, right? So please don't take this as some sort of referendum on like maximalist dressing or riots of color and print. I love that stuff, right? And it's been hard to let it go. And that's why this has been such a dramatic journey. I think most of you know that, but I just had to say it. For me, having too much color and print and pattern on me, on my body, with my personality, with my lifestyle, it made me feel kind of overwhelmed. It was like too much on top of too much. And nothing really had that purity, that strength of silhouette and kind of impact, shape and form that I wanted to have. That's like the stuff I love the most about art and fashion. Nothing had that because it was all overwhelmed by each other. Everything was too much with itself, with each other, and so nothing could really stand out. So a blue bag like this in a wardrobe like that, I feel like wouldn't stand out in the way that I want a piece like this to. But with the wardrobe I'm sculpting, that's calm, that's serene. A piece like this is such a statement, right? It stands out so beautifully, stands out starkly. The contrast, the power of it. And I feel more motivated to keep almost all of my wardrobe neutral so that I can carry a bag like this potentially. Or what I would really love to have in this color is like a coat. Can you imagine a bee like me dressing in like all cream and black and camel all the time, but then having like a coat in this blue? And that coat is always just going to be glowing against that neutral backdrop, you know? So I am looking forward to very occasionally investing in a piece in a strong color. Not right now. I'm not buying clothes right now. I'm not buying anything right now. But what I am going to do is go shopping in my closet and choose what to keep. And I am going to be keeping a few statement pieces that have the strength, the punch of color in my wardrobe that this blue bag has in this image. Basically, this image really clarifies for me why I will be making those choices when I make them. So I'm thinking of like, I have this bright red cotton sweater, I have a red wool sweater, and I have that bright blue sweater. And I think all three of them will function kind of like that bag is functioning. And that's really exciting. That's really the only place on my mood board here that we're seeing that. There is one printed dress. And I think that we can talk about print in the same way. So this is an old image because I know that this website, Totokalo, I never knew how to pronounce it, Totokalo, is now defunct, I believe. Yeah. It was like an online boutique that ran for a long time, curated really amazing stuff. And actually, I feel like I never bought anything from there because it was all expensive designer stuff. But I would go on there and browse for inspiration and just think about style. In my memory, it was a mostly minimalist fashion in that it was really all about unusual silhouettes, striking silhouettes, slightly off the beaten path. But then they would incorporate some statement pieces and some prints, but they would always be this kind of print that somehow does work with a wardrobe like that. This print makes sense in a wardrobe of all neutrals, and it's partly because it is a neutral print. It's also partly because it kind of walks the line between floral and graphic. I think that there's something about that. It makes it feel modern, but not too of the now, like not too trendy. This print really looks like it is both very contemporary and vintage all at once. And there's something about this that is helping to sort of teach me what kind of print I might want to have in my wardrobe and what kind of prints I might want to keep in my wardrobe. Not just prints, but clothes that have more than one color in them. Like clothes that are a little bit more complex in terms of the way that they're put together, the kind of statement they make, things that have a stripe on them, things that are bi-colored in some way. I will be, I think, keeping a few items like that from my existing wardrobe, adding them to my capsule wardrobe. And this is the principle, this sense of like freshness and timelessness at the same time. So that image is really helpful to me. Wow, I feel like we're making so much progress. I've really, by looking at these images, taught myself to understand how I might incorporate color. Well, first, number one, it was realizing that I want an extremely neutral, extremely limited palette in my wardrobe. Two, it was understanding how I can add pops of color to that. And three, it was understanding how I can then add print to that. We could end the video right now, but we're not going to because there's a lot more to talk about, a lot more beautiful images. But those were kind of the heavy hitters. That's the stuff I've been stressing about. And it's amazing how quickly it all fell into place when I just backed up and looked at this Pinterest board that I've been creating. So just briefly, that old video of mine about, which one was it? How to find your personal style, that video. There's one of those videos. It's either that or how to make your wardrobe match your lifestyle. And I probably mentioned it in both of those, but this idea that rather than just kind of casting out blindly and going trial and error, trying to find what you like, the idea that you can save money and make better decisions and have a more cohesive style if you sit back and just plan a little bit. Like, figure out what you want based on what works for your lifestyle, what your actual practical constraints are, what you like to wear on your particular body, and what you like to wear kind of as you move through your day, what you actually find yourself actually putting on because it'll feel good on you. Based on all of those things, informed by all of those things, make an actual plan. I've just talked about it a lot on camera and recommended that people do it and said that I would recommend it to my past self if I could go back in time. But here I am doing it, and it's just working better than I ever dreamed. You know, I mean, here I am doing it. I've done this before, but I feel like I'm at a little bit of a crossroads here. Like, things are changing. You know, my personal style is changing. And since it really started changing a lot, this is the first time that I've sat back and done this pointedly. And oh my gosh, it's just, I feel relieved, energized, and I feel like I have clarity. So we've answered those big questions. Let's look at some other images of note. Weirdly, when I was pinning some images, I don't know, a couple of weeks ago, and I was thinking about this video, I was thinking about what I thought that I was going to see when I looked at the board and backed up from it and thought about it. I remember saying to myself, I'm going to see that I've pinned a lot of images of loafers and blazers. And I'm going to say on camera, oh, it looks like I need to keep an eye out for a pair of loafers because I don't really own like those thick soled platform. Any loafers, but the ones I'm thinking of are like the ones with the thick sole, quite chunky loafers that I've kind of had my eye on for a couple of years now, like as we've gone into the winter season a couple of times in a row. But I'm looking for them and I don't see the images that I remember pinning. I feel like I remember pinning a bunch of images with loafers and I don't see them. There's this one of the woman in the very dark green sweater and loose jeans that she has like loafer type shoes on. I guess here's another one, this long textured kind of brownish gray sweater with pants, trouser pants that match, a soft black leather bag and some loafers. I like this look. I like that other look. I do think that I would get a lot of mileage out of some shoes like that. And I am keeping an eye out for some loafers. Actually, there's a pair at Cezanne. I have already picked out the loafers that I want to buy if and when I can buy them. But I, in my mind, thought, are these also loafers? So yes, this image of a very simple look, black t-shirt, black trousers, and a wide black belt with socks, and they look like loafer slides. Those are also loafer-ish. So I do think that a pair of loafers would fit into this closet, right? Would fit with this aesthetic. But it's interesting that I didn't actually pin as many outfits that actually have loafers as I thought that I did. What I am seeing a lot of are flat, soft ballet shoes, flat sandals, which we're going into winter right now, so maybe not as much that. Flat pointy shoes, flat mules. There are just a lot of flats. And I don't really have flat shoes like that for the winter. I've got my chunky boots, I've got chunky sneakers, and I have besmirched ballet flats up, down, and all around town all over my videos about new fashion trends that I've made like for the past year. I'm always like, ballet flats never look good. Ballet flats aren't cute. Ballet flats fall apart. Ballet flats are a piece of garbage. Like, I've really not been into it. What I thought I was going to say about loafers, though, I think I'm going to say about flats. I think that a pair of really well-made, like structured glove style flats would actually serve me well, work well with my lifestyle, something I can just slip on, would work with all of my outfits based on what I'm seeing here. The dream, these amazing ones, are these like hair on hide, these like pony hair, burgundy, brown. Oh, Pinterest is showing me the brand and it's Maylene Burger, sold by the Frankie Shop, $650. Probably not them, but yeah, something like this that has some character. And it wouldn't need to be these. I mean, if this was just plain leather, something like that would be amazing. So I am going to keep my eye out for that kind of thing. And this board is really teaching me that I might like that kind of thing and that it would work well with my wardrobe. I wouldn't have thought of that on my own, but it's clearly true. Kind of like the winter version of my Birkenstocks, my black Birkenstocks. Another thing that I'm seeing here as I sit back is that I appear to be interested in incorporating a little bit of slightly more feminine styling into my wardrobe. And I have been a little bit aware of this. I've been thinking about it and it's showing up on the board here too. This gorgeous Cezanne shirt, white with like a lace ruffle all the way down. I wouldn't have been comfortable in this last year. It would have felt like too frilly, like making a girl out of me. Now I see how beautifully this can strike the balance between like structure and softness. And I would really love to wear a shirt like this. And I know that there's stuff like this in my wardrobe that I haven't really been wearing that I can choose for my capsule wardrobe. So that's really exciting. The same with this Doen top, like the lace or crochet, slightly puffed sleeves, little stand collar. I don't have this shirt, but I have things like this, things that give this vibe that I just haven't been wearing lately. And I'm really excited to build my wardrobe around or including the neutral versions of the blouses like this that I have collected and worn in the past. So I was talking about potentially buying a pair of loafers or a pair of glove flats, but I really am mostly looking for what to keep from my existing wardrobe, not like things that I might buy to enhance the capsule wardrobe. It's very clear the, you know, oversized sweaters, the things that are cream and black and taupe and camel, like those will be the shoe-ins. But I'm looking for things that are curiosities, like things that I've pinned that make me realize, oh, I should probably keep XYZ in my capsule wardrobe that I wouldn't have necessarily realized. Trousers of every kind, definitely. Absolutely. Trousers, high-waisted, wide-leg pants, basically, are in almost all of these images. And it's interesting. I used to feel like pants like that were a little bit too formal for the everyday for somebody who works from home. And lately, they're all I've wanted to wear. And I've really gotten used to pants like this as actually kind of casual. It's added up to looks that have elements of polish, like the fact that there's a trouser pant, that make me feel more put together than I otherwise would and make me feel like I've really gotten dressed for work. And that's been important to me the past several months. Things have been so chaotic. We're at home so much. So it just helps. Like a pair of trouser pants that are loose and comfortable helps me feel really put together and actually helps the outfit look really great, especially given that I am creating content, you know what I mean? I'm like posting my outfit on Instagram and I'm sitting down and filming and sometimes filming myself, my entire body when I'm filming fashion content. So I am dressing for work, you know, and for morale. But the softness of these kinds of high-waisted flowy pants makes me still feel comfortable and not feel like I'm putting something on that's like, that feels really constraining and stiff and that I can't wait to take off at the end of the day. So those trouser pants are a really strong presence on this board. And luckily, I do have several pairs, some more casual, some more formal that I have collected over the years because I really love the silhouette, but I just hadn't really gotten myself to the place where I was wearing them and loving to wear them regularly. But now I have gotten to that place. So that's going to be really exciting. And if you saw my pants declutter, then you will know that. You saw me trying on like those pants from the sample sale in LA, those men's pants from ASOS, like all of those pants. They're about to go into heavy rotation. I can tell that from looking at this board. My eye keeps coming back to this image. What is it about this image? The color of the pants and the fact that they're so incredibly oversized. I actually have a pair of pants this color that can be this oversized on me if I wear them really low-waisted. So that might be part of what is alluring me here. I think it's a combination of the extremely slouchy clothing. Like these pants and this sweater are swallowing this model hole. Like this person is absolutely swimming in these garments, but the bag is very chic. It's this little fashion crossbody. The bracelet is a bit dressed up, the nails, and then the pumps are, they look like high heels, although they could be flats, but they're also very dressed up. So I really like this combination of very soft, slouchy, oversized clothing that might as well like be pajamas with accessories that pull it together and make it kind of sharp. That's something that I am kind of doing today, actually. I'm wearing this, I mean, this is like a wrap top, and I'm wearing high-waisted sweatpants with it. So if you were to look at just the clothes, the silhouette's there, but it's a bit on the casual side. But then I'm wearing these accessories and nails that are very much like polishing it up and pulling it together and making it sharp. And if it were to add a pair of strappy heels to this, it would be like sweatpants we hardly knew ye. You know what I mean? I mean, they're here, but it would really make it so I could go anywhere in these sweatpants. I like that. And I think that that's kind of one of the principles I'm going to continue to think about as I put together my wardrobe. This absolutely stunning image from the brand C with the brown sweater over the brown dress, but they're kind of two shades of brown. Like the sweater is like a green undertoned brown and the skirt is like a burgundy undertoned brown. It's clearly a dress because the listing, it's an ad, right? It's on Pinterest, but it's an ad that says Kareth dress. Oh, it's like sold as one item. It says the Kareth combo dress features a cozy knit sweater and voluminous cotton slip dress in a monochromatic burgundy colorway. Anyway, that's stunning. Do you remember that wild, oversized burgundy dress that I kept in my dress declutter? And a lot of you were like, don't keep that. A lot of people in the comments were like, why are you keeping that shapeless burgundy business? This is why. Because I could put a sweater over it and it can be just like this. The same is probably true of my white linen. Do you remember that white linen dress that goes all the way to the floor? I could put a sweater over it and it would belong right here on my mood board, be right at home right here on my mood board. I'm not sure what more there is to say. I mean, the interesting thing about this is that I'm not going to look exactly like any of these pictures because I don't own any of these clothes. Like, these aren't my clothes. And I'm not going out to buy clothes to make myself look like this. I am just using this as a guideline for myself when I decide which clothes to keep. So this is very exciting to me. And I can do this with what I own, you know, because I have similar things to some of these things. But it's like separating fashion from specific items. Like, that's sort of the takeaway that I'm having here at the end. I've also learned from this something that I did know already, but it's like been reinforced and brought into my conscious mind, which is that I'm looking to put together outfits that feel extremely comfortable and effortless to wear, but have a sense of polish, a sense of pretty high polish, like level 4 formality workwear without crossing over into extremely formal workwear. I am very interested in that. Trousers, belts, jewelry, nice polished bags, sunnies. Like, I feel like those trappings of sleekness and almost professionalism are helping me at this phase of my life work better, like helping me get up in the morning, helping me stand up straighter and get through my day as somebody who works from home and who has a small baby and is just exhausted, like kind of running on empty. And it doesn't take very long for me to quickly slide into feeling really not put together, like really, really just like a blob rolling through my day. And I'll still get stuff done, but I won't feel like I'm sitting up straight. I won't feel good, you know? So I am kind of articulating this for the first time here on camera. I've been leaning really hard into things like wearing a belt with my outfit, wearing some slightly nicer shoes when I go to the grocery store in order to just help myself pull myself up. And now that I see this mood board and I see, like, yeah, there's a lot of softness here. But what I'm seeing in all these images is that softness is being kind of hemmed in and polished up and given legs by structure and polish and some sharpness. And also potentially, like, and by the kind of brutalism of the monochromatic color palette, kind of. All of it's working together to create a sense of balance and also to create something that has enough oomph and enough, yeah, like masculinity. And I mean that, I don't mean like a man. I just mean it as like the yin and yang. You know what I mean? Like enough yang to really get me going, make me feel like I have gotten dressed, not even just feel, make it so that I have gotten dressed with a capital D, you know? So I'm looking at this and I'm like, okay, I want to build a wardrobe that's soft enough to keep me feeling cozy and hygge through the winter, because I'm thinking about fall, but that is polished enough, sharp enough, chic enough, and yang enough to get me dressed with a capital D every day. That's it. And I want it to be black, white, cream, and camel with very few pops of really strong color. I'm so excited to do it. And was that the other, there was one other thing I was going to say. Oh, it was that thing about separating fashion from garments. So I have realized, finally, we got there after almost an hour of filming. We got there, everything I just said, but we got there with these images of clothes that I don't actually own. And I'm going to execute on the brief with clothes that I do own. So it just goes to show us once again that fashion isn't about buying the exact garment in your inspo image. And the way that you look and feel, you don't have to build it out of the specific things that you see other people have, buy, wear, etc. You don't need the exact pair of trousers. You just need a pair of trousers that works for you the way that the thing is working for the other person. So I appreciate that this has shown us that as well. And now I'm going to go, actually, I'm going to go film another video. And then I'm going to go very soon build my fall wardrobe out of my existing collection of clothing. And I'm going to do it along the lines of these principles, and I'm going to film it. So keep an eye out for that video. Thank you for being here. And don't forget to take extra good care of yourself so that you can be the most effective version of yourself as you do your work in the world.